Hi guys, welcome to Tutors Funny channel. In our last video, we discussed about the colors, how to use the color. What is the use of the colors? In this tutorial, I'll show you. I gave user admin different color and engineer different color, and there will be the various roles. I given the each roles different color. Okay, now let's see the example. So here, James as an engineer, type as engineer. Password I have entered. So here, this is not a password text field, sorry for that. I just drag and drop the password text field over here. Okay. Text. TXT pass. Okay. Let's run and check. If I enter James, password engineer, click login button. Here it will be the color has been changed as a green. If your role as a John, you will be able to see the color as admin type. Here red. If it is a Peter, color as blue. Okay, the user color has been changed. It's okay accordingly. Okay, this is very important stuff. Okay, I have given the different color. So how to do this program step by step, I'll be explaining. Okay, so what I'm going to do is here. First, I'm going to go to the file, new project, Java application, click next. If it is create main class, you have to uncheck it. Java login. Okay. This is the example. So I am going to go to create a form, new JFrame form. Here login. This form name I'll give you as login. Hit finish button. Here I am going to create the form. I already create this one. I just copy and paste. This is very simple. So how to create the form? If you don't have idea, I'll help you explain it. Drag the login. This one you have to log in. Select this one, properties. You have to bold with 24, or if you change it as 66, perfect. After that, I drag the panel, right click, properties, no border, bevel border, click OK, drag the label, username. Okay, you have changed as world. Here I have dragged the text field. World with 14. Right click, edit text, backspace to remove the X instance, select again, change variable, TXT uname. Right, select this both, hold on control key down and select both, control C to copy, control V to paste below. This one should be password. TXT pass. Drag the buttons. Control C to copy, control V to paste and get the end of the copy. This one should be the cancel. Okay, now what I'm going to do is here. You select this text field, name it as TXT uname, TXT pass. Okay, now first go to the database. I have created the table database which name is student info. I have created the table user. This is the user data I have entered. I have created four fields, ID, uname, password, utype. This is a username I have entered. Okay, John, password 123 as admin, Peter 321 as a receptionist, James, this is the password, the role mean, it is a engineer. Role I have created as a user type. Okay, you can type here as role. Okay, that is your wish, right? So what I am going to do is here, I have to do another important stuff is role. I forgot to create this one. Should be the not text. This is a password text field. Select this one. This one select as bold with 40. Select this control C to copy, control V to paste. This one should be role, user role, your role. Role, this one should be the combo box. You drag and just drag and drop. Properties. Here you have to different role. You have to create admin. But roles you have to create admin. These three roles. You just copy, paste over here. You just comma. You have to type another role. Okay, so I just copy these three roles. I have created engineer and receptionist. Hit finish. Right click properties with bold 14. Right. Now what I'm going to do is here. I'm going to go to what I'm going to do here is login. Double click the login button. Double click login. Just copy. Paste over here. You have to create the first. You have to create the SQL lab java dot SQL. Okay. You have to create the connection of this connection object con. BST, that's it. Okay, so this one should be txt pass, txt uname. Okay, txt use type, user type. Okay, perfect. Right, now the MySQL driver I'm going to attach it. Select the library, right click properties, sorry, not properties, right click add jar folder. MySQL connected. Select all, down control key down, select both. Right, perfect. Now what I'm going to say, have add the database name and table name correctly. Okay, all the stuff are there. Now let's execute the program. This RS object also we have to put the RS object. Result set object also we have to do put in the result set object. RS. Perfect. Right, first we have done the login form. I'm going to create the main form as well. I'll be explaining it. So right click, main form, finish. Click on this one, some main. Right click properties, font bold with 24. Drag the panel over here. Right click properties, border, bevel border. Drag the labels. Username. This one border 24. Control C to copy, control V to paste. This one should be the change txt user. Control select both, control C to copy, control V to paste. This one should be the u type. This one u type. T select both, select this one, change the txt type. Okay, perfect. Now what I'm going to do is here, I'm going to explain it. First, these are the user, what is the password and username you type and enter. Here I have created the, first you have to create the connection objects, con prepare statement object, object pst, rs, object rs, okay. After the text box name, which name is txt uname, I have gave here. Password I gave here, txt pass. What is the value you type on this text field? It assigned to the relevant fields here. What is the user type you are selected? It assigning here. After the first you have to register the MySQL driver. I have already imported to here. MySQL I have registered. This is the connection. Okay, this is the path where your database is located on. The localhost, which name is your database name is employee. Localhost employee. That's the path we have to given. This is the user credential of MySQL. After that, we have written the connection PST. We have written the connection query PST equal connection prepare statement. We have to check the username and password along with the role. Both are correct. So select all from user via username and password and utype. These all are parameters. You have set it to the values of the form values. What the value you entered over here? It says if all are correct, it's successfully visiting. Otherwise, fail. It show the error. So here, this is not an error. I want to this uname, username, and utype both I have to. If the username and password role are correct, I will be passing this value into my main form, one form to another. So how to pass it here? Click on this one. This is not an error. What is the problem? New form main. It asks import here. Click on this one. Here it create the constructor of the main. It automatically create the constructor main. Okay, click on this one. It will be automatically imported here. Okay, so what you are going to do here is you have to set it this one as a public. Then only it should be work. Okay, you have to set it this one as a public. Initial component you just cut and put it over here. And here what I am going to do is here we have to do the couple of things. Over here, domain. My previous project, I have closed it. Right here, this one. Variable I have created and put it over here. And well, we explain. Don't worry about that. If I go and do it, take too much of time to complete it, you are so boring. Okay, perfect. I have done, right. So this one, our LBR user, we have to select this, we have to change the name. This is the label now, so type this change LBL user. This is the, we have changed this one as a LBL user. LBL user type, that's it. That's the thing you have to do, right. What I am going to solve the stuff are correct. Now let's run and check whether it's working fine or not. John, let's click on this one, properties, sorry, source, click on this one, control F. Here we have the UI, change select as metal, run this one, but it won't change. Okay, this one, login, UI, metal. Okay, here, if you enter the username as John, James, password 123, engineer, login, here it's working perfectly well. What I did here is, what is the username and password you entered here? It passing to the, what is the username and user type you entered? It passing to the, this main, username and type. It's coming here. It is setting the username over here and type you set it here. Okay, after that, string you type. What is the user type you are coming here? It assigned here. Now you have to check what is the user type you are coming here. It will be checking. Okay, here you have to, what is the user type you are display here? It you have to check. okay, it is check. Okay, if the user type is coming from admin, we have to change the name LBL user text. We have to change it as a red. So we have to check this one as LBL user set foreground color red. Okay, this how we have set it. This we have created two variables. This is a class level. This is the parameters variables. So this one should be the class level data. You have to set it as a parameters variable. So it will be covered. So here we have to, if the user select, if the value coming as admin, the color should be as red. Red, what is the context we want to be changed? The user text as well as a user type. Both are we have set here. We have, this is the property which is changed. Set foreground, set foreground. If the values are coming as a receptionist, we change it as a blue. You can see a blue. Okay. Otherwise, is there any other color, it will be changed as a green. This is how the programming should work. Okay, very simple. You must do it. If while doing any error or any something else, you can ask me, let me know. I'll be help you to do it. Thank you for watching.